This is a $20 Windows XP laptop that I just bought over an online store, and we're gonna test this laptop to the max. Here's the box. It comes with a big box to protect the laptop, as you know, of course. There are so many shreds of newspapers to cover the laptop, and also the bubble wrap. It's thick. Setting the box aside, we can see the laptop, but first we will take a look at the charger, as the seller of the laptop didn't include the charger in it. Yes, I bought it separately. As I expected, the charger comes nicely in the box, and now we can open the wrap and take a look at the laptop. It took me so long to finally uncover it. Aside from the sticker artifact, it's very well in condition, which is very rare when it comes to a laptop, with only $60 for the laptop and $4 for the charger. Anyway, plugging in the laptop to the wall, and we'll see that if it actually boots up and worth the price. The power button glows. Oh, alright, turn it on. Wait, a modern Windows logo on a 2009 laptop? That's something I haven't seen myself. Alright, we're in the OOB, and as we can see, this laptop came with Windows 10 from the last owner. And here we are on the desktop, and by looking at the WinVer, it's Windows 10 version 1607, the anniversary update. Thank God it isn't 1903 onwards. Within the system information, we can see that this is an x64 laptop with Intel Core 2 Duo CPU T6600 running at 2.20GHz with 1GB of RAM upgraded to 3GB, which for 2009 is quite decent. As for the graphics card, this laptop is using Intel GMA 4500MHD, which is okay for me as I'm not that interested in the gaming part of this laptop, but more of an experiment part of it. Looking at several ports that are available with this laptop, we got an RJ11 modem port in here, a DVD optical drive slot, as well as a USB port. On the left side, we got an AC adapter port, RJ45 Ethernet port, VGA port, USB port, HDMI port, and another USB port, headphone jack, microphone jack, and lining jack. At the front, we have a card reader, surprisingly. So far, the laptop is really packed with ports and slots. When it comes to operating system support, there are a bunch of support for this laptop, both officially and unofficially. Windows 7 is the first operating system when it comes to the official support. I was surprised when the raw installation automatically utilizes Aero, since the graphic driver is Aero appropriate and Windows 7 is what the laptop was supposed to be pre-installed with. Windows 8.1 does kind of the same thing with Windows 7, but with drivers needs some automatic installation with driver packs, except the graphics card, which I installed it manually. As for Windows 10, it behaves the same as Windows 8.1. Windows Vista is a bit tricky here, since it's further than XP, but interestingly, it seems to not have any drivers on driver packs. But after digging a bit deeper, I eventually found the drivers, and they sort of works, as you can see in the Welcome Center, but I can't get the error working here though. Windows XP has two separate cases. The x86 version installs perfectly with few drivers needed to be installed manually, and then you're good to go. But for the x64 version, not 64-bit, those two are different, it needs to get a little adjustment as it doesn't support AHCI mode and it doesn't detect the hard disk. So I have to manually change the mode to IDE in the BIOS, and the rest is good. Windows 2000 is not installable in this machine. It's just stuck in the setup is starting Windows 2000, just like some of you who are stuck to not subscribe to this channel. So click that subscribe button so that I can reach 6,000 subscribers and beyond. No pressure. Windows ME just hangs on this part. It doesn't even want to load the setup. Oh, I think I forgot about something. Oh yeah, Windows 11. Although it's not officially supported in this laptop, I got it to install right here anyway. Although I have to emphasize here, it's friggin' slow. As for Linux, Ubuntu Mate successfully installed in this machine, although with few drivers missing and I'm having a bit of a trouble finding one, which really pushed me back. Well, some of you may know, Can it run Crysis? Well, before we start there, let's just do some benchmarks in here to see if it's just okay to run Crysis. By using Windows 7 as its best operating system support, we got two benchmarking programs, 3DMark 06 and Cinebench R11.5. With 3DMark 06, this laptop seriously suffers to get at least 1 frame per second most of the time, and by the end, it only gets about 647 as a score. As for Cinebench R11.5, using CPU tests, the laptop results at 1.24 points. Yeah, I think this laptop isn't really gaming ready, especially Crysis. With a variety of operating system support as well as acceptable performance for its era, this laptop is very good bargain for its price. Now, a question you might ask, what OS am I going to install onwards on this machine? Well, I'm going to install Windows XP on this laptop in order to keep it with so many future videos I want to create. If you want to suggest me what video that I should make with this laptop, you can join my Discord server. The link will be in the description of this video. Oh, wait, what is that? Is that Windows XP? Well, better check out the video after this. Meanwhile, like and share this video. Thank you to my supporters for making this video possible. And also don't forget to check out this video.